Hello viewers, it's KAY FELIX here and I welcome you to my YouTube channel KAY FELIX INSPIRE. I would like to say a very big thank you to all of you for the support and the contribution you are giving to this channel. If you are new to this channel, please do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I post new videos. Stay tuned for more details in this report.
We cannot be dealing with the same questions every day and still getting the same answers every day, but people continue asking about the same things. So we hope that this is the last time we're going to talk about it and we move on to other things as a nation. Remember that number one, this is not an outright overall audit per se. It is strictly and exclusively a verification exercise of an overall domestic debt, which sharply rose from 51.82 billion in 2016 to 76.4 billion in 2022 as of June. Just like other multilateral organizations like the IMF had to verify the authenticity of our external debt before coming to support our local economic recovery program, we too, as a government, need to verify this huge local debt deal, especially after finding pockets of fake or air supply in ministries such as that of the local government, where you had people bringing delivery notes or bringing certificates for payments for purporting to have supplied goods and services when in fact not. So with that kind of discovery, it is only important that you verify everything that consists of the local debt. The verification is across all ministries, parastatals, and government spending agencies. Hence, the Office of the Auditor General is overwhelmed. We only have one Office of the Auditor General that is supposed to deal with all government institutions and wings. And as we speak, there's a verification going on in all government ministries, all spending agencies, all parastatals. So, naturally, the Office of the Auditor General is overwhelmed. And the Auditor General made it clear and in writing to the Minister of Finance that the office is overwhelmed with the workload and therefore sought the permission of the Minister of Finance, and in accordance with the law and the powers vested in the Office of the Auditor General, to seek for external hands to help, meaning to bring on board private firms to assist the Auditor General. Remember that they have not come on board to come and audit, they say. They have come to verify. These are specific matters, specific issues. So, in accordance with the law, the Auditor General informed the Minister of Finance of the workload and the need for procuring external hands, and again, in accordance with the law, and after satisfying all procedures, the Auditor General procured the services of 6 private firms and allotted them tasks as follows. Number one, EY advisory was given to verify fuel. Number two, client focus was given to verify awards and compensation. Number three, Mark Daniels was given to verify VAT refunds. Number four, CYMA was given to verify phishing. Number five, PwC, or PricewaterhouseCoopers, if you like, was given to verify road contracts. And number six, Grant Thornton was given to verify goods and services. So considering this is not an all-out audit, but a verification process of targeted specific areas of concern, the auditors only have access to files relating to the claims accruing to the date. Meaning that these auditors, even as we have put them in government institutions, and the one which is of concern are those that are verify the claims in the Ministry of Defense or the Defense Forces. It's not like they've gone there outrightly to look at all the files in the Ministry of Defense. They have gone there to look at specifics, and they are looking at goods and services. And those files they are looking at are being given to them by the Ministry of Defense. So there is no risk or iota of risk of these auditors having sight of any other files or documents relating to operations or anything that may be considered a danger to national security or an exposure to the security of the nation. They are there in the room that they're working from, and they are being given the files to verify. There's money being owed by the Ministry of Defense and other department wings. But before the money is paid out or the final debt is known to be, this is the actual debt, there's need for verification. So they are law. It's just to verify. Are these claims genuine? Are all the documents attached? Is everything that is supposed to be there, there? That is all they are looking at. They are not looking at how many guns we have as a country, how many bullets we have as a country, how many tankers we have as a country. They've got no idea of business to do with that. And besides, even the documents that they are looking at, like I stated earlier, they are being given by the authorities. It's not them going out there and opening files and opening cabinets to get any file they want. They are being given by the authorities to say, the money we owe is this much, and we owe it to Company A, Company B, Company C. And here are the documents. So now there's a verification process going on. So, to this effect, we want to make it very clear that no law has been contravened, as is contained in the Constitution and as it relates to the Office of the Auditor General. No law has been abrogated. The issues that are being looked at by the auditors are verification issues, and if you are talking about them verifying how many bullets we have, no sir, there is no such thing. If you are asking if they are verifying if you supply the cafeteria, if you supply the beans, yes sir, there are such things, because you are owed money, you need to be paid. Now we also know that there are some unscrupulous characters that have hidden in ministries, including of our defense forces, where they've supplied air. By air, I mean where you have not supplied but purported to have supplied, and you are even on the list of those being owed money. I can tell you in no uncertain terms, it will not happen. Let me repeat what I said in Mazaboka. If you supply the government air, you will be paid air. So don't think that if you supplied nothing and you found your way on the list through corrupt practices of people being owed money, that you cash out. Not this administration. If you supplied air, you'll be paid air. If you supplied goods and services and they're verified and they're genuine, you will be paid your money. So in this regard, we want to make it clear that there is no breach of the law. There's no breach of the Constitution. The Office of the Auditor General is on terra firma. Ministry of Finance is on terra firma. And there are no issues to do with the Constitution being abrogated. Therefore, the issue of impeachment of His Excellency the President by the opposition, based on this core particular, falls off. It becomes a laughable manner. It is preposterous. There is need for impeachment, yes. Impeach your brains. Acquire new way of reasoning as opposition. Provide checks and balances that are beneficial to the country. Impeach your current thinking. But on the other side, there is no need for impeachment, and it doesn't arise. And the matter that you raise, if it is at all based on what you think happened here, it is laughable. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Unless there are questions. Yes.
So, I'm finding that people are telling us. I wanted to find out that the civil societies, they are calling on the Minister of Information that the access to information. So, as a minister, what are you doing to make sure that you meet their demand?
The issue of the access to information bill has moved. It has already received the what you refer to as having been agreed to by cabinet in principle, and as assured by the minister, this matter will be tabled before parliament in the opening of the first quarter of next year. So we can assure you that next year this bill will be enacted. Any other? You don't say anything. You have no patience. About the time.
Yes.
The members of parliament, they are saying that they are going to report concerning the same hiring of the private firms who have been hired, as you have put it, very fine. The supplies of goods and services to the military. Yes. As government, are you worried that they are going to court concerning the same?
As government, we want to encourage them that if they feel that they have got a case in as far as them claiming that the constitution has been abrogated in this episode, they are free to go to court. In fact, we encourage them. But what we will not do is to continuously play chochise by keep answering them, asking the same questions every day. We're giving them answers and they still come back with the same questions the following day. We can't engage in such kind of games. We are serious people. We've got a country to run. And therefore, if they feel strongly that they have a case, let them go to court. We encourage them. We shall meet them in court. In fact, we wish them good luck.
Director, there's another concern that the companies that were engaged, there was no transparency in this election because governments just endorsed the companies to audit, to verify the same information that came out. What is your comment in regards to that?
Again, I want to urge you as colleagues in the media that always take interest in what is going on. There was a tender over this. 12 companies bid it, and out of the 12, 6 were selected. How can the issue of single sourcing even arise? There were 12, it was an open tender, 12 companies bid it, and 6 were picked. So how can somebody say today claim that there was single sourcing? There was no single sourcing. And that is why I encourage you scribes, please ask questions so that we verify matters. Because today, you pick up this news and go. Then tomorrow you come back with an headline, the single source. It's the same thing that happened in FISI. There was a long discussion over single sourcing, over companies that were not single source, but were actually, they went through a whole process to be selected. Even in this manner, there was an open tender, 12 companies participated, and in the end, 6 were picked. Nobody was single source. Yes.
My name is Mukwema Jilala from Millennium Radio. Talking of verification, Director, at the press briefing held on, it must have been Thursday or Wednesday, Mr. Winter, opposition party president, made a serious allegation that the president could be connected to the two companies that were awarded the contracts in relation to the Ministry of Defence, and they challenged the president to state his interest or connection in any, because according to them, he may have worked for one of the two companies and was a partner. So I'd love to get government's position on this.
Yeah, again, if they feel strongly that they have a case in that matter, and they feel they they have strong evidence suggesting that there was mishandling in the whole matter of favoritism. They are free to go to court. But for us, we advertised, we selected six, and we gave the six companies the work to do, and they're doing a good work. Now, whether people work for them or not work for them is neither here nor there.